Hello friend, I am Rajesh, faculty from Electronics and Telecommunication Department, Goa College of Engineering. In this part, I will be talking about types of electronic components. Electronic components are classified into two categories, namely passive components and active components. The three basic passive elements used in electronic circuits are resistor, capacitor, and inductor. They play a very important role in how an electronic circuit behaves. The first passive component, we look it as a resistor. A resistor is an electronic component which limits or regulates the flow of electrical current in an electronic circuit. It is measured in ohms and denoted by a Greek symbol omega. It is also represented in different color codings. We can get the values of this by using different color codes. The next passive component is capacitor. A capacitor is a passive electronic component that stores energy in the form of electrostatic field. The effect of capacitor is known as capacitance. It is measured in farad. The third and the important component is inductor. An inductor is a passive electronic component that store energy in the form of magnetic field. The effect of inductor is also known as inductance. It is measured in Henry. Now we will try to understand the next type of electronic components called as active components. Active components include amplifying components such as transistors, vacuum tubes, tunnel diodes. Whenever you need amplification, you use transistors. Transistors are basically classified into bipolar junction transistors and field effect transistors. Most of the recent devices in microelectronics basically use the concept of field effect transistors. We have active components such as diodes, Zener diodes, tunnel diodes, light emitting diodes. Some of the special active components are also shown here, such as UJT, which is unijunction diode or a double base transistor. It is used in power control switching devices. Next is general purpose silicon control rectifier, where for power device it is used. Power ending capacity can be increased with this. Mainly the controls are achieved with the help of thyristor family, that is SCRs. Then you have photo transistors, which you see in application of alarm systems, etc. Now, just pause and have this question. Think and write. Whatever we have seen in the previous presentations, answer this. What do you think is the difference between an active and a passive component? Thank you. Thank you very much for your kind attention and patient hearing. I hope you enjoyed the session. I request you to please complete the two learning by doing activities allocated after watching this video. Thank you.